To summarize, the most pertinent findings would be, number one, history of asphyxia by plastic bag suffocation. Two, pulmonary congestion, edema, and hemorrhages. Three, schistosomiasis of the liver. It's an incidental finding. It's a parasitic infection. I believe he comes from Leyte, Samar area, and that's kind of endemic in that area. Number four, status post autopsy. Number five, status post embalming. Number six, evidence of medical intervention consisting of a needle puncture mark on the dorsal right hand. Well, this is, I saw this on, you know, zooming in on the pictures, and I'm not too sure at this point if the Bucor Hospital did this, because sometimes when you bring bodies to the hospital, they automatically try and look for a vein there. I don't have records of what they did, what they saw in that hospital, but this is not really that significant. All right, and then I have here an opinion, and it reads, this is the case of a 42-year-old male who was an inmate incarcerated at the New Bilibid prison when he was allegedly found unresponsive and pronounced dead at the NBP hospital on October 18, 2022. The cause of death was certified as, in quotation marks, dead on arrival, undetermined, for autopsy. The embalmed remains were autopsied on October 20, 2022 by the National Bureau of Investigation. A second autopsy was conducted on October 26, 2022. There is information that he expressed fear for his life shortly before his demise, and that he died from suffocation by means of a plastic bag over his head. The autopsy finding showed no gross morphologic cause of death, and this is consistent with the reported asphyxia. Limitations were encountered in the examination due to the postmortem interval, the previous embalming and autopsy. Preliminary urine toxicology showed methamphetamine. Based on available information regarding the circumstances surrounding death, the manner is homicide.